Okay, so today we're gonna be repairing this WASD keyboard. Why is my exposure bad? Okay, so today we're gonna be repairing this WASD keyboard with an enter key that doesn't enter. Don't have spare switches, so we're going to be using this keyboard as a donor for the switches. So we're going to start by this keyboard is dead, so basically been keeping it as a donor for spare parts. This screw. Okay. Now, how do you open that way? Yep. Oh, this is smooth opening. Oh. This comes off real easy. If you're wondering, this is a, I believe, $40 mechanical keyboard right there. Not really the best of the best or anything, but was good when we got it. Okay, do we have more over here? Got clips at the bottom, so a bit harder, but I think we get one more clip. Yeah. Okay. Cover came off. Sorry for the interruption. Okay, so now that I have this, can I move that? Okay, so now this died because the microcontroller fried over here, I believe, when it got water damage. So something here, I think this thing died, I don't know, doesn't matter. Gonna look at something that doesn't look too, you can see water everywhere. I'm gonna look for a key that seems fairly good. I think this one looks good. So now normally I would Kapton tape this, but this is already dead, so I don't mind breaking it more. Okay. So I have a SumSauer 8586 soldering station. Gonna be heating that up to turn it on. Oh, yeah, back switch. Gonna be using this solder right here. So, gonna be using this. So this is 0.6 millimeter solder. So it's it does have lead. That's the right one. Okay, so I'm preheating the soldering iron to 350 Celsius. I'm gonna be using a little bit of solder wick to desolder this if it doesn't work with the desoldering pump I have right here. Okay, so we're gonna be doing this boy over here. Now Yeah, it's this one. Now, I don't know what traces go where, so I'm just gonna desolder a big blob here. Yeah. Now, I do have some solder to rework near the enter button right here. Like, I have this here that lifted slightly. And I need to rework. I'll be cleaning that up first, though. But I'm gonna be getting a key first, so let's go. Okay, now this is hot. So we'll start here. I am not good at this at all. No, that was good. Pretty sure I got everything. I'm gonna take this one off just in case. It won't harm anything if I do, because this is already dead. Okay. Turning off soldering station now. Okay, now let's look at our shit work. And here we go. Okay. It was those two. Great. Okay. So we got this off. Presume this is a pretty good switch. So that's good. I'm gonna probably take like these later on, but for now, got a switch from an area that doesn't seem too water damaged. So that's pretty good. Gonna be putting this switch where this enter key switch is. So we'll see in a bit. Okay, so now we're on the receiver board. I do see a couple of problems right here, here, here. There's a couple of unfortunately residue. I'm gonna try to wash first using some isopropyl alcohol. And a brush for boards. So this trace is starting to lift up. That's not great. Yeah, it's not great. But doesn't mean it's unrepairable. Do have a couple corroded connections, but nothing too drastic. Should be good. There's no like bad connection anywhere I can see. Just a dead enter key. So we're gonna be doing that. Now, got my spare key here. Pretty sure the enter key is right there. It says enter right here. So if this is the enter key, I'm pretty sure it's this. Yeah, it's this one. Looking at the layout, it's probably like this. So it's these two pins. So we're gonna be removing these two. Preheating my my soldering iron. So that's good. Gonna just have a little bit more here to. Now I'm using flux core solder, so should be good with that. Okay, so let me close the eyes with propanol, and we'll do that in a minute. Okay, so there's a few areas we need to protect since we are going to be applying heat. I'm going to be using some Kapton tape, or as this is called, Koptan tape. It's off-brand. It's going to work the same regardless. It's because Kapton tape is much more expensive than it needs to be. So, okay, then. Okay, so want to protect right here, since I'm going to be working there, I'm going to protect around it. Okay, this is to prevent excessive thermal stress. I'm also going to be desoldering this with solder wick because doesn't look like a job that will be good with anything else. So let's start cleaning up over here first. Now, let's desolder you. Yeah, no solder wick ain't working for that. So I'll be using same method as before. I think that's desoldered properly. Good. I'm gonna do this bad boy here because I want to reflow it. I fucked up. Okay, now our enter key should pop out. So let's just, okay. And over here, let's just, good. And lift the lever, and it should just come out. Okay, we have our non-working enter key. Gonna be putting this working key instead. So I want this to be like this. And here we go. Okay, now it's just soldering it in and reflowing this area here. So I'm gonna start by this area right here. Put some fancy additional solder. Do not breathe in the smoke. The magic smoke is not good for your health. Okay, now I'm gonna healthy blob. Okay, that looks good, yep, just gonna remelt this a little bit so that we don't get cold solder joints. That's good, yeah, that looks perfectly fine. Gonna go test this to see if it works quickly, and I'll be back if it doesn't. This is the old switch, and now if I turn it around, we have a new switch. Okay, now the keyboard has been repaired. We'll be reassembling it. So now I didn't record the disassembly because, well, the assembly is the disassembly in reverse. So we have right here a little connector. That's what gives us our USB connector. On modern ones, it's a USB-C. This is micro B because this keyboard predates the USB-C standard. I'm just gonna give the corners a small scrub with a brush because there's a little bit of crud on there. The rest can be cleaned when installed, but at the very least, the edges kind of need a little bit of TLC. So we'll be putting this in like so, but then We need to connect this connector, which we re-soldered. I have tested the keyboard. I'm not, like, if you do any repairs, test it just like this, like no screwing back, no nothing. First, to see if it works, because if it doesn't and you reassemble the whole thing, you're gonna be very, very sad. Okay, now this is back on, that's good. This, yeah. Okay, so now there's only three screws on this entire keyboard, I believe. No, four. So one of them goes right here between the F3 and F4 keys. I don't think you can see. I'm gonna move the fire extinguisher so I can move this. Should always work with a fire extinguisher when you're working with high temperatures. So we have a screw hole right here, and that's the only screw that's black on the entire build. Every other screw is silver. So this is the only topside screw. This will keep the keyboard in place. Good. Well, at least that's the only one I found. Now we're just gonna put the overlay back on. So it's mostly just clips. So you just clip it back on. Okay, technically this could be held like this, no problem, but we're gonna screw it back on. Now there's a do not remove screw here. Right to repair is a thing, so that's completely bullshit. There is no screw under this. It looks like one, but this is a plastic, like, I think this is where the injection mold happened. Fortunately, I didn't break it, but still. So, screw one, screw number two is underneath the kick foot. Same thing for screw number three is underneath the other kick foot. Okay. This is screw number three right here. The kick foot, as you can see, have little notches like this, and the notches, what they do, they allow you to press them so that you can not only remove but put them back. So do one side and then you just side push like this, and here we go, it's back. And the same here, you got to be careful, there's an inlet crease on one side, the other side is flat. This is the side that wants to be facing you. So all you do is you align it, then push it back in, and here we go. And now we have a working WASD keyboard. You do have these two little pins that go on top here with the metal bracket. Those are to hold the enter key. They also exist on all long keys, including spacebar. That's why I can press here and this side goes now. You just need to bracket them with the metal, and the key itself has holes in it. So that's it. We went from a broken green Cherry MX switch, which I love because of the click, but we got a brown now because, well, this is all I got to spare, so hope this helped someone.